Salvi experience, and it's good to see you after the time due to COVID-19 disturbances. Hopefully, we will continue our remaining lectures through this online session. Today, we are going to start our chapter 4, that is about CD cell. And this one slide first in this is showing you the outline of this chapter, what we will cover in this chapter. Probably most important topics, maybe not in detail. So, starting with the definition of CD circuit, CD circuit is actually a circuit that provides only one path for current to filter. Means there is only one path, like in the sequence. So, CD circuit, we can say that is a six-way circuit that is actually providing only one path for current to flow. So, when there is only one path for current to flow, then it means same current is going to be passed from every junction, no matter how many resistors are there. But the voltage may be. So if you see this example, you see there are three bulbs which are connected in the series. The application of series circuit we will see in the when we have the lighting into the marriage halls, somehow in the torch, somehow it is in, application is in the twice, the child building twice. This you will see that in the this series circuit. There are three bars which are connected, and they are connected not, you see they are connected, the negative with the positive of another, and another positive with the negative of another. This provides series circuit, they are sharing their current. So when they are sharing their current, the actual current is going only one path. So they all have the equal current. So if you see here, for an example, in the series circuit, you will see there is a one battery with two connections, two resistors, positive, negative. There is only one flow of the current from a resistor from the negative side, electrons flow to the connecting wires through the resistor 2 and through the resistor 1 with the positive side. So this way, that is actually the series circuit in pictorial wiring diagram that's showing the battery. Another one is the schematic symbol diagram that's showing you the applied voltage when there are small dots in the circuit that actually show you the electrons, free electrons, which are moving through the resistor 2, the resistor 1, and going to the positive direction at the after applied voltage in the positive. So this is, you see, there is only one path for the current to flow. So this one path for current to flow makes it the series circuit. Now, series circuit, this one is the example where we have connected three valves, which are connected through the series valves. Now, here two resistors then are connected end-to-end with the opposite ends connected to the terminals of the voltage source. You will see this. So this way, actually, the current when having some same path, the current remains the same throughout the circuit. This figure one in the chapter 4, and especially the B that represents the free electrons with the small dots. And notice that the free electrons have only one path to flow as they leave the negative terminal of the voltage source, flow through the resistor 2 and resistor 1 and return to the positive terminal. So this is a very simple series circuit where two terminals end-to-end connected with each other and having same voltage source, and they have only one path to flow the electrons from one end and another end. So that is series circuit. When there is only not only one path, means there is an alternative path, then we will say that is a parallel circuit. But this time it's only in the series circuit. So then there is only one path. Now here you see the same example, but since there is only one path for electrons to flow, current must be the same in all parts of a series. So whatever is the current, that will be the same from one part of the to another part. So it is known that an electronic current is the movement of charges between two points produced by the applied voltage. We all know that current is the movement of the charges which is provided by the applied voltage. So between two points. So this, when components are connected in successive order, and that's another definition, like figure one, they form series circuit. The resistors in series with each other, and the battery, and also the battery. So that is actually the successive order, sequential order, or we can say series order of between two points where current flows through the applied voltage. So current is the movement of electrons, movement of the charges between two points, and it is the other. So it's very clear that when two points have only one path to flow the current, to provide message to the current, that is called a series circuit. Now, why the question arises that why the current remains same in the series circuit. We understand, but we say the free electrons moving from one point to are continuously replaced by free electrons moving from adjacent point in the series circuit. So, an electron having the same speed as those leaving the battery in all parts of the circuit. Therefore, the electron drift in the same is the drift. The electron drift is the same. Flow is the same. Electrons, we can say movement is the same. So this equal equal number of electrons move from one point at one time with the same speed. That is why the current is the same in all parts of the series circuit. Of course, when there is only one path and there is only same space, same speed, same time, when one part of the electron goes to another part, they have the same speed flow to another. So this way they create same drift, and that's why they create the same number of electrons. And now we can say, with the example, we can say there's one is you can see here the electrons are in the circuit A and B. That's a schematic symbol of the your circuit, which is showing you that electrons are flowing from A to B point, then to C, then through the resistor B point, then okay, 1 minute. Okay. So this way. From E to F, G to H to J. So you see there is same one point to another, the electron flow is same. All there, every junction there are same. Some three electrons jump to another part and three speed go to another part in another. So this creates the same electrons. So small example, in the B you see there are 2 amperes of the current which is moving to the from A to B, then B to C. From every resistor that is same, 2 amperes from every junction from A, B, C, D, E to F, G, H, R, to J. So you can see there through the resistor 2, 3, resistor 2, resistor 1, same number of electrons are flowing, these 2 amperes of electrons are flowing. Because the 3 electrons at every point are the same. When one 3 electrons jump to the another junction, then with equal speed, 3 electrons available there, they drift to the another point. So this way, they create the same. So the lower symbol is showing you the series circuit, which where there is a 3 electrons connected in the there are the series circuits with 3 circuits which are the current electron, and they're showing you the series circuit part. And you see, if we go to the 4.2 example again, you see there the battery supply the potential electron that causes 3 electrons to drift from the negative terminal at A, B. And so through 3 resistors to J. But negative battery terminal with negative charges repels electrons. Therefore, free electrons in the atom of the wire at the terminal are repelled from A to B. So you know there are free electrons available at any terminal at every point. So when they repel each other, they go move to the further. So they move with the same speed and the same length. So this way they produce the same current. At the same time, the positive charges of the positive battery terminal attracts the free electrons, causing electrons to drift towards I and J. As a result, the free electrons in R1, 2, 3 are forced to drift towards the positive terminal. The positive terminal of the battery attracts electrons just as much as negative side of the battery repels the electrons. Therefore, the notion of free electrons circuits are at the same time at the same speed. Now, if you are not clear, let me clear to you that when there are the positive terminals and negative terminals, positive negative terminals repels the simple electrons towards the positive terminal attracts them. But as there is no any alternative path, they are similarly they are through resistors, but at same speed and same length they attract and they repel. So this creates the same current. So you see this one is also the one of the example of the series circuit. Another example, that's connection that is showing you the impact series components can be defined as those in same current paths. We already know the series circuit or series components or series parts are everywhere in the series circuit, they have the same current path and save the same current. One side of the voltage source through the series components back to the other side of the voltage source. However, series path must not have any point at which the current can branch off another path. In series circuit, there must not be any other branch or either path, so that in other ways they would become the parallel circuit. You know, the parallel circuit mostly in our home fitting of the electricity is actually a parallel circuit, where same voltage is applied throughout the all connections, but in series circuit, same current is provided. You here see in the circuit A, there are voltage, total voltage, and the current having only 1 kilo from resistor 2 to resistor 1, but their points are connected with the, there is no any other branch. So similarly in the B, similarly in the C, you can see that there are three circuits, 3-2-1 resistors, but all having, you can see from in the C especially, you see the voltage going out of, is through the resistor 3, resistor actually then resistor 5, then resistor 4, then resistor 3, then to the other two. And also there is no other pattern. Similarly in the voltage D, you can see there is a 5, voltage is coming from 3, then to 4, then to 5. This is just reverse order is compared to C, but there is no any alternative path. You can see from C, 3 to 4 to 5. But in the C, you can see from 5 to 4 to 3. So similarly, you can so go into the E. That is a different shape, but actually there is only one path. That the resistor 5, then 4, then 3, then to the opposite direction. So you see there are the series circuit different formats, but however, there is only one current path. Then we have this example of series circuit connection. Self review in figure 4.2b, name 5 parts that carry the current of 2 ampere. Now you can go to the 4.2b, and this one is the 4.1, but 4.2b. That 4.2b circuit having 5 parts, name them. Now you can name them from the A to the B. But in the A, there are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, R. But you can see into the B, you have the voltage applied. You can give a name to them, and so around where that make them points. So like so then we have in figure 4.3e, when current is 5 ampere, current in the resistor 5 is 5 ampere, then our current in the resistor 3 is. So you can see if it is a common sense that if there is a series circuit, whatever the resistor position is there, the current will be same. But for confirming, you can see 4.3A. So 4.3E is showing that 5 resistors, 5 having this one, then you can see same current characteristic. Then figure 4.4B, how much is the current in the R2? 4.4B, how much current is in the resistor 2, but we don't have any figure 4.4V. You can see 4.4V. How much is the current? Current will be the same. So let's see here an example. In order to solve the values of voltage, current, resistance, series circuit, we can apply Ohm's law. You know, the current, in order to solve this voltage, current, and resistance series circuit, we can apply Ohm's law. It is called IR. And if you want to connect current from there, you can say voltage divided by resistance, and you can say so. Similarly, Ohm's law will be helpful for you. But two resistors are in the sequence, so whenever we want to connect, the total resistance will be equal to resistor 1, 2, 3. How many resistors? And there will be total. If there are three resistors, with 1 with 5, 2 with 5, and R is a 3 with 10 ohms, then it will be 3 ohms. It's simple. If the total resistance is connected into series circuit, that is actually simple, very much total of the total resistances. So we have to collect in the sequence, so R1, R2 plus R3, how many resistance. And then there is another example that when this voltage 80 volts supplied across the series circuit, then how much is the current in R3? So you know the current is actually through Ohm's law, we know that through the voltage supplied divided by the resistance. So when 80 volts, 80 divided by will be at the resistance. How many resistors are there? Total resistance is 20. That will be 4 ampere. And so the current at the resistor 3 will be 4 ampere. Why? Because current is remains the same. So current is, we know that it is 4 ampere, that will be either resistor 1, 2, or 3. No, this is just for the confusing view that at what will be the resistor 3. But even current will be same to the office. this was actually the series circuit for today. So instead of lingering on this topic, I am continuing my current topic. I am focusing on the topic per topic for each lecture. So hopefully you understand. Now you have any questions on this, I'll stop this video and we will continue. So we stop video here and